Ow.
Hello everyone and welcome to Paragon. My name is Dinosaur, but you can call me Dino, and today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. I am going to be casting my own first game of PvP in Paragon, which is the first MOBA that I've ever played, except for one very terrible game of Dota 2 that my friends forced me to play a long time ago without telling me how to play. But we got through that, and now we're going to get through this. Let's see how it goes. Alright, here we go. Start of the first game. Here we are playing Feng Mao. That's me, right there. Dinosaur. This is the first time I've ever played Feng Mao. I played Gideon a lot in solo versus AI matches, trying him out, trying to get a feel for one character. And then by the time I got to this game, we could see that this other guy here had picked Gideon over in the top left. It put me in an awkward situation, but I decided to deal with it. I saw that none of my team was going right side, so I started going right side from mid where I had originally started. I went through the jungle, I believe that's called. But as I said, I am not experienced with MOBAs. This is a completely new experience for me. It was very awkward, and it worked. It worked, I guess. You'll see. Here we are, just clearing some minions, making sure that we get our minions a little bit further. I think that's how it works. And that type of shit going on for a bit. As you can see in the bottom right, we have picked up the shield, I believe that is. As, once again, first time playing Feng Mao, had no idea that the shield was not a particularly valuable ability in general. I mean, don't get me wrong, it can save you from some really great shit. But generally not a good first ability from what I can tell. From my two games I played after this, much prefer something like Hamstring, which I have just unlocked right there. Hamstring, very good. Very, very good for doing combat against other players, also known as PvP. Killing them magically. Here you can see we got a Severog coming up in the front, coming to try and fight us. I have no idea how to do PvP, really. Now we're gonna try it. This guy just misses his first attack. I'm just like, oh, okay. Well, I'll just let my minions start attacking you then. I'll come in for a cheeky hit now and then. And then I remembered that hitting the hero in the front of the tower makes the tower start attacking you. So I just sort of back off, wait for more minions to spawn. I can level up here. I don't. It's alright. Who needs leveling up when it's the right time? You can see another guy coming in the bottom left over there. Half health. I didn't know he existed at that time, but I'm about to find out. And it doesn't go very well for him. This is the point where I notice that there's two of them. It's okay, the Severog stays back at the tower. Well, the Greystone tries to push me when he's at half health. I kill him and then instantly go for the Severog, realizing the huge advantage I have just gained. Using all of my new abilities, I have unlocked everyone but the ultimate because I don't know which ones are good enough to be worth upgrading. I back off, heal. Not worth even thinking about losing a fight. Because I got a kill, and if I can get out without dying, then I am just ridiculously ahead overall. We go back to heal. We could recall, but place is about as close as it would take to recall anyways. Just decide to sprint there. Sprint there. Sprint there. And here we find that our Richter has been sitting in spawn the entire game. And he is now following me back to the spawn. No idea why. He just sort of stands there beside me. As if I'm going to, like, lead him to battle. To glorious victory. He's just gonna stay there. Just gonna stay there, not gonna go anywhere at all relevant to the game, and that's perfectly fine as a valid tactic to be 4v5 in any game. I mean, I don't know how much it affects MOBAs, but I know in every other game that I play, being a man down in a equal team versus team fight type of game, you know, generally puts you at a disadvantage. Here we come back to find that the Greystone is back, and the Severog never left. He's still at 1/3 health. So we're going to kill the minions. They're going to go for us, but I'm going to take out the Severog real fast. Ooh, except that. That hurt a little. Severog's going to get too close. He's going to die right there. I don't know why he did that. He should have backed off. He killed himself. Greystone doesn't realize that I still out-DPS him at this point in the game. He tries to run at this point because that's when he notices. I'm faster. I catch up. I hit. The thing I love about playing Feng Mao against Greystone... Oh, Murdoch came to help me at the end there. The thing I love about playing Feng Mao against Greystone is your range is just slightly longer than his, so you can play it really well where you're kiting backwards and you can hit him but he can't hit you and he's still chasing you. It's when he turns around and you have to start chasing him that you go at the disadvantage. Here I believe when I eventually level up, I do unlock my ult, which is really nice. I really like the ult. It's great at dealing with enemy heroes. It does so much damage so fast. It's just beautiful. We go for the minions here. I noticed that we have the Murdoch here, so I think, hey, if we can kill these minions, two man against a tower, probably a pretty easy take. So kill the minions. We've just got one here, but the next wave coming right in behind. So we now have five minions here. Kill this one real fast, and then we just go all in on that tower with our five minions. And let's see how we do it. We hit it. Minions are coming in. Still hitting it. Still hitting it real nice, real good. Three quarters, two thirds, almost at half. Here you can see Greystone coming in from the front for us, but it's their side. The tower's about to die. I back off because I realize that there's only the one minion left, but our Murdoch didn't back off, and therefore he died to the combination of the tower and the Greystone arriving. But we got it to half. We got it to half really fast, really early on. It was really good. I'm just trying to get the minions without Greystone getting me. Being very careful not to start a fight with him in range of the tower. I'm aware of my advantages and my disadvantages. That's why I played solo versus AI matches. I learned what not to do. And what not to do is take fights with enemy heroes where you can get shot by the tower. Because you will just get shot by the tower and die. Look at him blowing his cooldown. I stun him. Slow him. Hit him. Use my ult for the first time. Get rid of a large chunk of his health. Keep killing him while also killing an enemy minion up there when I took one swing at one that was almost dead. Got a last hit on it, which is very important in this game for card XP, which is basically just levels up your character. And then I kill him very easily. I feel like he was missing most of his shots there because he should have done about as much damage to me as I did to him. I am now level 7. If I remember correctly, at this point in the game, I'm significantly ahead of the rest of the team and the enemy team. Yeah, look at that. My team is 4-5-3-5, and then me at 7, and they are 4-6-4-3-4. 4-3-5, they got one person leveled up. Point being, I am very ahead in power levels, as opposed to anyone else that is going in this lane specifically. There's one guy who was close to my level, but I haven't seen him the entire game. He was not on the right side, and that is okay. Here we got some minion slaying, lots more minion slaying. Minion need to die. Need to kill the minions. I don't like minions. They die. I can see the Greystone coming. I back up the second I see we only got one minion left. I even charge out of there to make sure that I don't die to that. I run, knowing the Greystone will probably follow me. I try to bring him to a location where I have an advantage. And I recall while he can't see me. Very excellent. Very well done, me. I mean, you've done shit until this point, but you're doing alright there. Get some card upgrades, upgrading the cards. This point in the match, we are 4 kills, no deaths. Doing pretty well considering, once again, first PvP experience in a MOBA. Except for that one game that was not told how to play of Dota 2. Here we can see Greystone in the distance. Knowing how it's gone so far, we know we can take him in a one-on-one fight. He's still level 4, we're level 7, he doesn't even have his ult yet. His ult is the thing that makes him very hard to kill as any other damage dealer. Because it makes him come back when you kill him. It's a passive. He doesn't have to activate it. It doesn't do a lot of damage or anything. It just means that when you kill him, he will come back at about 60% health, which makes him ideal for 1v1s. Here's me learning how to use a harvester. It said stand on the harvester pad, so I stood over there. But little did I know it meant this, so I stood over here, and now it works. Now it's collecting card power. Real good. Real great. Some tearing over there. It's fine. Greystone ran away. You can see him in the jungle over there. I'm gonna kill some minions, killing the minions, doing well. Clearing the lane, hopefully, so that I can just take out that tower nice and easy. Here we go, attacking the minions. We're right in front of the tower now. We got just the one minion out with the next wave behind. Make it nice and easy, take this tower. Should be the last push on it, if I remember correctly, because we're doing well. We're hitting stuff hard, hitting stuff fast. We got another level up that we have not spent yet. I hate when the minions with the lowest health just run in the tower first, because then it's just a one-shot. Doesn't help much against anything. Going for the tower. There's only two minions left. I think I do have to back up one more time. Yeah, there we go. Charging out, making sure we don't get it by the tower. That's just unnecessary health loss. Here we are, clearing the minions. I learn how valuable the ultimate is against the minions right there, as I just cleave through four of them with just the one attack. I would have saved it for a human, knowing how useful it is against humans. But haven't seemed to be against any humans recently. They just seem to be not caring about my existence. Letting me take the right lane all by myself. I'm farming. I am killing. I'm just having a generally good time, not interrupted by the enemy players who have learned to fear me by this point in the game. Clearing more minions, we're going to go right for the second tower, because I still haven't seen any enemy players coming to get me, because they're all focusing on other places, and that's fine with me, because I'm just bursting through this right lane all by myself, no opposition. And by no opposition, I mean when I do have opposition, I completely destroy them. Here we are. I figure we'll go for the minions first, clear them out, because we're obviously not going to get the tower on this wave. Best thing we can do is make sure that we clear these minions so that they can't attack our next wave of minions, so that we have more minions going into the tower on the next wave. It's the smarter way to do it, in my mind, at the time. I don't know if that's the better way to do it overall. I still don't know after playing two more games after this. I have now officially played three games of PvP, and that means that I know pretty much literally nothing about this game or MOBAs in general. I feel good. I feel good about it. This point in the game, I'm just like, fuck yeah, I'm a badass. I'm a killing machine. I'm killing all the enemies and all the minions. I broke a tower by myself. There's no one stopping me. I'm unstoppable because they can't stop me. I'm level 10. All these other losers are like two levels below me at the highest, and that's one of our guys, so they're even better. Like, what the hell are they even doing? I'm carrying, and this is my first game. Like, what the hell, guys? You might as well be minions. That's how I feel right now. And I feel honestly offended that this much weight is being placed on my shoulders. But, you know, I'm capable of dealing with it. And I'm happy. I'm enjoying myself. Having a really good time. Was expecting to be having a lot worse of a time for my first time here. Ooh, here you can see that someone from the enemy team is coming over here. I believe that is Kalari? Kalari. Coming. First time I've seen Kalari, I'm just like, oh shit, what the fuck are you? You're melee. Why did I start attacking you in the tower? I'm stupid. I took a lot of damage for no reason. I guess I'm gonna back off. Think about how to deal with you, because you're scary, motherfucker. You are scary as hell. Gonna go back. Gonna run. Do I go to collect the harvester? Yes, I do go to collect the harvester here. Good, good. I was aware of the importance of the harvester at this point, collecting card power being a useful thing. And, do I just go back in? Don't even pop a health pot or anything, you fucking idiot, piece of shit? Me? You don't think that might be useful? At this point I notice that the minions are pushing without the player. I figure, hey, maybe the player ran off. Probably safe to just go back at it. I mean, I probably could have killed him anyways, but you know, if he's not here, it just makes my job easier. So I do it. I kill shit, I keep killing shit until my minions get through. Break in to the tower. Oh, I've suddenly been attacked from behind by the guy I saw earlier. The guy with two swords, the scary motherfucker. He doesn't have much health. I start wailing on him. He's missing a lot of hits. I'm not. He is surprisingly squishy for how scary he looks. I'm just gonna use my ult. Take away an entire third of his health all by itself. Does a really good job of clearing him. Then I just beat up through these minions, beat up through everything except that thing I probably should have killed. I still don't know what it is, I just know that it's good to kill it. And I recall here, knowing that I'm in need of health. I'm out of health potions, as you can see in the bottom left. I only have one mana potion. It's much more efficient to just go back, get our health and mana back the hard way. Well, not the hard way, more so the easy way. And get our stuff back, look at our cards. We just spent a lot of card power, because we just built a lot. We built a lot, we were alive for a while, we were out there for a while. We got at least a couple of kills while we were out there, farming minions, collecting from the harvester, and now we're going back out. Here we go, we find this thing. Do we kill it this time? No, we just run right by it as we go back in, not even acknowledging its existence, going straight for the minions. Having a great time doing it. I'm still feeling really good about the whole thing that's happening. Not sure how my first PvP experience is going this well. Literally only played against AI up until this point. Never played this character before. Surprisingly, very much enjoying myself, very much having an easy time of the whole thing, charging through it. Not sure how it's going this easy. Just took out the second tower like it was nothing. Now staring at the inhibitor, doing a lot of damage with my left click right now, because I am so much higher powered than anyone on their team. I am now three levels above the highest person on their team. They had two level 8s, at this point I'm level 11. Their towers are like a piece of candy to me. I eat them for breakfast just as I eat their minions as a light snack, one at a time. Here comes Chimera. This is the first time I've seen Chimera. Scares the shit out of me. And just ultimate kill him. So not really that scary in the long run, but he tried. He tried. He sure did try. Here we are, going back in on the inhibitor as soon as our minions get here. You can see two of them spawning and going for me. I'm not sure I notice yet. I probably notice right about now. Yep, there we go, backing off. Knowing that I'm not going to take that fight in front of the inhibitor. He uses two of his cooldowns and misses. And I just go in there. I'm hitting both of them at this point. It is 2v1 for them. I back off. He knocked me away, which is good for me because I am fully aware that I shouldn't be fighting both. Even though I did about as much damage to each of them as they did combined to me. At this point, I see only one of them is chasing me, which means it's an easy kill. I should go for it. Hamstring him. I missed the hamstring, really. Try to catch up with my dash. Hit him twice. Hit him a third time. He's gone. Easy. Now it's 1v1, me against Severog. I have more health. I output more damage. I know I have the advantage here. I just need to get him to a spot where he can't run away easily. Because if I have him with his back facing his side, he can run back to the tower. Easy. Made him waste a cooldown. Now's the time to go in. We're on his side. Here we go. Let's start hitting him. Ooh, he hit that cooldown, but we hit the hamstring. He's running. Charge him? Charge him? Nah. Back off. We know better. We don't want him to run past the inhibitor. If he runs past the inhibitor, then he's safe. What we're gonna do, we're gonna wait. He goes in for it. I don't know what he's thinking there. I have more health than him. I do more damage than him. He goes in for the kill. He fails. I murder him instantly and insanely. Here we have a new challenger coming up to the fold. It's Chimera returning. I've just killed two of them for free. I realize that I am at about just over a third health. I see this guy coming. I'm just like, why would I fight you? I just got three kills. I'm just going to run back and heal while making you chase me the entire way. Because for some reason you are intent on killing me right now. This point in the game, I am now 8 kills, 0 death, having no problems. I'm level 12, which is still 3 levels above their highest guy, as they now have a level 9. But below that, they only have the one level 9. I'm now 4 levels above the majority of their team. I now recall from here, even though it's sort of silly close. I'm just like, you know what, I'm not going to walk the whole way. I'm lazy, and this just gives some stress off of Feng Mao's legs. Because we all know that Feng Mao's legs are very, very precious, very fragile beings that need to be pampered at every point they can. Here we are, as we're charging back up the right lane, we notice, oh hey, Harvester's got some card power in it, might as well pick that up, good for us, good for our team, let's do that, yeah! As you can see, we've also been doing a good job farming. I've been told that these numbers are very important. Higher this number is, the more powerful you are. Look at how much higher mine is than the other team! I've got 33! They've got 15, 18, 18, 15, 18. Regardless of my level, that number right there, the card power number, which decides which cards you can activate, which just make your character better as a whole, that just sort of, like, objectively shows you how powerful I've gotten myself without them being anywhere close. I'm now level 13. Highest person on their team? Still level 9. I'm ahead. I'm significantly ahead. Look at the damage I was doing to that inhibitor. So fast, so easy. One auto attack is a large slice of its health. I ult here, I'm just like, fuck it. I can take the inhibitor on the next time my minions spawn. Might as well get rid of their minions nice and fast so our minions have the best chance, and I can have the longest time just straight up attacking the inhibitor. Best chance at killing it. So I go for it. I go for it hard, real easy. Look at that. It's about to fall. There it goes. So we're just like, yeah, party time, kill all the minions. Kill all of the minions, because now this is my fucking lane. I have now gotten rid of two towers and an inhibitor. You can see Greystone going up on the right. I know he's there. I know he's there. I'm backing off. I guess I didn't know he's there. I'm just sort of playing around here. Don't really notice him. Still don't notice him. We go off to the jungle for the first time. Or no, we go off to mid. You know what it is? I realized there was a huge fight over there. I'm just like, you know what? I've cleared all the way to the core. I'm going to have some of this team fight action. Because I've been getting no fucking action over on the right lane. I walk past another one of those key things. I don't know what they are. I walk over here. I'm just like, hey, look, an enemy. Oh, shit, he's gone. Might as well finish him, I guess. I don't see him. He's Kalarian stealth. I have no idea where he is. But, all of a sudden, there he is recalling. Oh, fuck you, buddy. Sorry about that, you chose a bad spot to recall. Poor guy. So we kill the minions, we're just like, you know what, we've opened up the entire right lane. Might as well help these guys just clear out the middle. Be a nice teammate, because we spent the entire game playing for ourselves. We see our teammates beating up this thing. The first time we ever kill one of those things is when we see our teammates doing it. And do we just walk away for whatever reason? There we go. Here we go. We find Chimera. And we're just like, hey, I'm gonna ult you. There is literally half of his health gone in a single swing, as he is one of the level 8s, which means I am 5 levels above him. His health number is so much lower than mine, and my damage number is so much higher than his, that I do half of his health in a single attack. It's beautiful. We're just sitting here helping our team. We're just like, yeah, I'm still gonna farm the card power, because as much as I like you guys, as much as you're on your team, I mean, like, I want the most card power, because I'm a badass currently. I can 1v1 anyone on their team. I can even 1v2 some of them, as I have proved up to this point. Let's just take out this inhibitor, have a second lane to the middle open, and, oh shit, he's gone. I was gonna kill him. Where'd he go? Oh, hey, he's behind us now. I guess I'll go kill him. Look at this. Watch this. Auto attack right there. Just chipping away at him. It's like 10% for auto attack. Our team just hits him hard. I help. Gideon gets the kill with his black hole. Well done on his part. Here we go for the core. I think we literally have our entire team here. Yeah, we have all 5 of us here. We just killed at least one of them. And they got guys, they got Greystone all the way back on our side of the right lane, trying to get rid of our tower. He's running back, realizing now that his team is in a very dire situation. We've got super minions all the way at the core, taking out every single one of their minions. We've taken out 2 of their team. He's still running back. He just recalled. Look at them. We can see 2 guys up there. Doesn't matter. Going for the core. Too important. Too big of a deal. Going right for the core, literally avoiding Greystone, knowing that, you know, we changed our mind. I was gonna say, knowing that the core is more important than the kill, but then we see him, and we're just like, well, hey, he's in a bad spot. I guess we can kill him. I guess. And right here, we just have a beautiful moment of, fuck you, Uri. Just gonna beat him up. He re-comes out. I'm just like, hey, I've got this beautiful ult thing. I could probably use this here. No, that's not when I do it. No, I don't have the ult here. Getting chased down by Kalari, as they want to kill me one time in this game. I can understand the sentiment, as I have been a big fucking pain in their ass the entire time. Look at me, I am now 11 kills, 0 deaths. They haven't managed to kill me once. I'm going to recall, make sure that they don't kill me a single time in this game. Getting my health back, getting my mana back. You can hear that little warning sign for them, as their core is in total disarray. They're having trouble keeping up with us. They got a kill, but is it enough? Is it enough? I'm spending my card power, getting the rest of my cards in position. I'm now level 14. Highest person on their team is now level 11. 2 of them had disconnected at this point. I guess they gave up. They understand that their team is not going to do very well here. They understand that their team is done. And that's victory. For me, in my first PvP match of Paragon, as Feng Mao, 11-0-1 with 76, whatever that is, minion kills. 76 minion kills, that's actually pretty good. Pretty good. We got a lot of card power, look at us. We're just supremely more powerful than anyone else in the game. Alright everyone, that's been my first PvP match of a MOBA, this time in Paragon. This has been the introduction to Dynocasts. Like if you like the video, because if you like, you might as well like it. Subscribe if you want to see more, and thank you for watching. Yeah!